Hey guys, it's Harley Wood. So today we're going to install a locker down console vault. I have had this in my wish list. Like, I keep a little digital wish list of things that I'm looking forward to reviewing or just having for myself. I've had this in that wish list for probably 2 years. And over the course of 2 years, I've been toying with the idea of selling the Tundra and finally paid it off and just come to grips with the fact that it's a great truck, gonna keep it. So I don't mind investing this money. And that's what had kept me from purchasing this over the past 2 years, was I didn't want to spend, you know, $200 to $300 on something if I was just going to sell the truck. Keeping the truck, went ahead and got the vault. And I work in downtown Atlanta. Some of the areas that I frequent are not the greatest of areas. And sometimes if I'm going into a place where they wand you or they pat you down or, you know, whatever, I'm not able to take my concealed carry. And rather than just leaving it in, you know, an unprotected console in the truck or in a glove box, or especially if you have to send your truck or car through valet, something like this becomes a little more desirable. Take your truck in for service. You know, you just certain things you don't want people messing with. So went ahead and got it. Has a 4-digit combo dial on it. I got the upgraded version that has a thicker steel. In fact, I think this steel here is thicker than some of the steel on gun safes that I have. And when I got it out of the box, I was actually kind of shocked at how heavy and thick this is. So I'm going to post a link in the description below where you can check it out. It's supposed to be a 5 to 10 minute install. It's probably going to take me longer to clean stuff out of the center console than it will to actually install this. Let me back the truck out of the garage so we have a little bit better light and show you how we put this in. Super simple. Couldn't really been easier. Initial thoughts are, man, it fits perfect. I mean, it was made for this truck. Now, this one with the upgraded steel is only available on not the current model Tundras, but the ones before. This is a 2011, and I think the year span is 2007 to 2014, something like that. So the only thing that I would change is that those bolts would recess so that they didn't cause the little pad in the bottom to kind of flare up where the bolts are. Not a huge deal. The lockup on this is super tight. I mean, it was custom built for this truck. It's measured to perfection. The door locks up tight. You're not going to have any jiggling or fluttering as you ride down the road. That would drive me crazy, so I'm glad to see this door locks up tight. And the combo lock seems solid. They have some other versions. They have a digital lock that's coming out, and then they have some keyed locks if that's what you're into.
I've also seen some people complain that you lose access to your power plug here. And that is true outside of the vault. You still can obviously access it. There's a cutout here. And I've also seen some people be pretty innovative and tap a small hole, comes out right here, put a little rubber grommet in it, and then run the cord out through that. So if you wanted to go ahead and do that, you would still have access to your power plug outside of the console.
So there's also a competitor to this called Console Vault. And price is very comparable to the non-upgraded thicker steel version. I believe the locker down one's $269 and the console vault one is $279, somewhere around there. The console vault one comes with a 3-digit lock, and it's, I think, $30 or $40 to upgrade to the 4-digit lock. The locker down one comes with the 4-digit lock for no additional charge. Ultimately, the thing that swayed me to this, though, was the locker down version has a bigger door. And if you go look at pictures, you'll see what I mean. It's probably 1.5 to 2 inches deeper. And so having that additional access to the inside of the vault is what ultimately swayed me in that direction. So this is what I used to use in the truck when I wanted to secure a firearm. And it has a cable inside, and you just kind of strap it around the mounting brackets for one of your seats or, you know, whatever else works for you. This is obviously much, much more secure than that. So much happier. Love it. I'll post a link in the description below where you can check it out. Thanks for watching, guys. If you like this video, please hit that subscribe button below. Got lots more videos to come, and we'll see you in the next one. Comes my jerk neighbor on a motorcycle. Hold on. All right, sorry about that.